Hello everyone, it's me Ilian from DM Trading Bulgaria, and today I would like to make a review of the trading plan I shared with you last week. So without further ado, let's get started. What you currently see on the screens is the Great British Pound Japanese Yen currency pair trading plan posted on TradingView. It is based on the H4 time frame. Just a few words about the plan. You can see a downtrend that started from this resistance area over here, and the price reached this support where just above it entered into quite long, for a few days at least, yeah, so about 10 days range. In that case, I was expecting either a break of the top of this range and move up all the way to that H4 resistance where this downtrend started, or a break of the bottom and of course a break of this H4 support, and the pair to continue further down to this H4 support area too, down here. In the meantime, if the range continued, I was going to look for short-term intraday opportunities on the M30 or M15 time frame by looking to sell the top of the range and buy the bottom. Let's see what happened with the plan. We can see that shortly after I posted the plan itself, the price moved up, went above the top of the range and started consolidating there for a while. After that, it just retraced below it. It went below the H4 support and then quickly reversed and reached the H4 resistance. Pretty unpredictable, to be honest. We saw a break of the top of the range, which gave us the idea to start looking for buy opportunities. Then we had a strong downtrend, which broke the H4 support area, telling us that maybe it's time to sell, and then just the price reversed again and went all the way up to the H4 resistance. However, if you followed closely the price movement, you could have made some decent profits out of this plan. Let me open the live chart and show you a few opportunities. Now, first of all, after this break, even if you took an entry here, expecting, I would take an entry here to be honest, expecting the uptrend to continue to that H4 resistance, you can see we had a small surge up to here and then the price quickly reversed. Let's see on the M30 how that looked like so we can discuss it a bit further. You can see the huge explosion up here and the price quickly retracing below again this previous top here. So in this case, you should have closed your position somewhere here, which would be close to zero or on a very small profit. However, then the price just consolidated here for a while and made a huge swing down, going below the H4 support area, which indicated that maybe after all, we are going to look for sell opportunities. However, since this down move, let me mark it, was pretty intense, it was a good idea to wait for a correction on this move and then look for possible sell opportunities. So a correction here would go up back to that broken support, which will turn into a resistance, and from there you can expect the down, the next wave down. However, you can see that this correction actually just brought the price back above the H4 support and just continued further up. So in this case, let me turn the M30, turn on the M30. You can see that actually after the break of the support, we had down here a short range consolidation just below it and the price went up. So it turns out that this break here was actually a fake out. You could have taken an opportunity here on this M30 candle for a buy trade. And then we had another consolidation here, but you can see the bottom of it was broken. The price retraced back above it, made actually this sort of consolidation here, and again we could have taken another entry here. And after that, it quickly reached the resistance area, where, as you can see, entered into a very strong range. So those were actually the opportunities on this pair. It was a bit of a messy ride, to be honest, quite hard to trade. Honestly, it would have been better if you just forgot about that plan and move on to a next one, since, as you can see, there were some good opportunities, but the movements were kind of messy and not according to the plan, so you had to constantly update it and, you know, find a way to make it profitable. However, currently on that resistance area, I do expect the price to maybe reverse the trend and form a new H4 downtrend, which could lead to some nice opportunities on the lower time frames for sell positions. Next week you can expect a review of the plan I shared this week with you, and on Monday I'm going to share with you a review of one very nice trade we took this week with our subscribers. It gave us a 1-to-4 ratio, so pretty nice profit. And I will discuss the plan behind it, I will discuss why I entered where I entered, and I will discuss why I closed the position when it reached a certain level. Expect that on Monday, and for now, don't forget to click subscribe and the little bell button so you get notified when we post some new videos. Thank you very much and have a nice weekend.